focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.
Owning a house of our own is something we all dream of. To some, it comes easy, and for others, there's PNB Housing Finance. In this episode of Quest for Excellence, we delve into the success story behind India's fastest growing housing finance company. Ranked as the fifth largest in terms of loan asset size and second largest by way of deposits, PNB Housing Finance registered itself with the National Housing Bank and started its operations in 1988.
The brand PNB Housing is now synonymous to ease and convenience. We have in fact traveled a long journey to arrive at this point. There has been a large endeavor from all the employees to live up to the promise of this brand.
The core strength of PNB Housing Finance lies in its dynamic, diverse and inclusive human capital. The human capital which is highly motivated, engaged and self-driven.
With over two decades of experience in housing finance, PNB Housing has a network of branches spread across the country which help its customers avail financial services seamlessly.
When we talk about the customer experience, there are various steps we have taken. Number one, we have in fact thrived to make best of both the worlds, which is the brand PNB, which is our parent, is a solid brand and a very well recognized brand across the country. We married that with modern operating procedures. So today we have solidity of a parent and a contemporary operating model. That's number one. Number two, we also worked on the delivery model. Today customers have much wider choice than ever before. Apart from the branch-based delivery model, we also worked on non-branch delivery platforms such as contact center, internet, digital platform, and we have also built a very strong in-house sales team which can deliver the products and services at the doorstep of the customer.
The PNB Housing brand is being correlated by the investors. They trust the brand, they trust the company.
On a consistent basis, our time to say yes and our approval rates are two ways in which we enrich our customer experience. So when a customer walks in any branch, the salesperson will handhold that person, do the documentation, get the file login, and thereafter the credit person takes over. And when the credit person is reaching out to customer at his office or his factory, he explains the total, the complete end-to-end process which is going to take place. And he handholds that customer till the dispersal time.
The technology that we created is completely in sync with the customer service that is expected out of PNB Housing Finance Limited. We have created a self-servicing customer portal, which is an interface between PNB Housing and our customer, through which they can avail the services which is required by them.
Efforts the company has made over the last 4 or 5 years has actually now helped us borrow or raise money very efficiently.
From a team of 148 in 2010, PNB Housing now has a strong team of close to 800 spread across the country. Founded on a philosophy that is geared to face various adversities, and with the right people, smart strategies and modern infrastructure, PNB Housing Finance is in an admirable position today.
If there's one company which has stunned markets, analysts and customers alike in 2016-17, it's PNB Housing Finance, India's fastest growing housing finance company. And it's not just performance or numbers which make it so admirable. is actually the tag that it wears very proudly, that of being very customer-centric and making home loans as easy as ghar ki baat. Today, joining me on this show is Sanjay Gupta, CEO and MD, responsible for PNB Housing Finance's transformation and its enviable position. Sanjay, thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you for having me over here with you.
All right, so 1988 is when PNB Housing Finance was set up, and 2017 is exploded, literally in everybody's mind or at the top of everybody's mind.
Thanks.
What was the tipping point? Was 2012 really the transformation year?
Manisha, a little before that, you know, in 2009 when PNB divested 26% in favor of New Silk Route, that was the time when the PPP came into existence. And the real, I would say, transformation journey started from July of 2010. And the implementation started somewhere in October of 2011. And obviously, people like you started seeing the results from 2012.
Mm-hmm.
So it was about, you know, a transformation, a very deep transformation on all the aspects of business, which commenced from 2011.
What was it? Was there a baggage of, taking over a PSU bank subsidiary? I mean, there's a certain mindset with which banks come in. There are several PSUs who did try and set up a housing finance company. Not all of them really succeeded. What was special about PNB Housing Finance?
Well, I think the biggest, I would say, hindsight is always, you know, more than, 20 by 20 or 16 by 16. But the biggest mistake which everybody made was to put generalist bankers into housing finance subsidiaries. Mm-hmm. And it is a misfortune that, you know, most of them rolled back. And it is a teaser for us too, because all those subsidiary companies of the public sector and the private sector banks used to have a deposit license.
Right.
And then they rolled back, and now new deposit licenses are not coming in way of the newer housing finance companies. So it's a big opportunity lost, and fortunately PNB decided to do a PPP and transform the company.
Mm-hmm.
So I would say it was lucky for us. It was very thoughtful.
So probably one of the rare successful PPPs in the banking sector, isn't it?
Yes.
Sanjay?
Yes.
I mean,
there are quite a few failure stories. This is something unique which has happened in the last, I would say, 2 decades or 2.5 decades. And this can be replicated. It is very easy. Just keep your focus onto the fundamentals and on people management, and you are there.
Talk about people management. I mean, how hard or difficult was it to take people along with your vision?
Okay, so we also had a cadre of people, you know, who came from the old regime. And it was very,
And you brought in some new blood as well?
Yeah.
So there was a combo, and it's always challenging.
Okay, so I will tell you what happened exactly. So it was quite a sort of a mystery for us that how do we take the old and the new cadre together. And in November of 2011, we did a development center along with a HR consulting firm. And the results were not surprising other than one. So the competencies, behavior, attitude and all was not customer oriented or business oriented. But Indians by nature are very aspirational. Everybody wanted their children to go to better schools. Everybody wanted to work in a more respectable company. Everybody wanted a better office infrastructure. They wanted better salaries. And that is where we capitalized on our people. And we promised there would be one cadre in the company and not two parallel cadres. And that is what is the biggest mistake most of the PPPs do, that they bring in laterals and the old people and don't merge them. And the rub-off effect was fantastic. Today, you can't make out. Nobody, even I can't make out who is from the erstwhile PNB Housing and who is a lateral hire. And skilling is one thing. Education, classroom, on the job, plus on technology has helped us a lot. And today, I'm very, very happy and proud that about 1,000-odd people who work across the country are all same. There's harmony, there's homogeneity. There's one thought, one objective, and they are all on one cadre and one HR rules, one handbook, right from the managing director to the junior most person.
And I'm just wondering, do you want to get more aggressive with your branch expansion? Because you've set 23 more branches, but you could actually be far more spread out, isn't it?
So, our branch network or our footprint is a challenge, it's limited. So, but that is also our opportunity of growth. We have a very defined and an efficient hub and spoke model, and our branches are the spokes, and they just do acquisition and servicing of the customer. They don't do mundane work like accounting or branch bank reconciliation or tax payments and, you know, payments to vendors and all. That's all centralized in our COPS and CPC. So I think it is the target operating model, plus our people. Our people have responded very, very well.
So going ahead, Sanjay, would you like to keep that efficiency? I mean, so you should be the envy of other banks.
Well, I want to improve on it, basically, because, you know, if the per employee efficiency goes up, then, you know, our OPEX will come down, our operating costs will come down. Our spreads can improve, our margins can improve, and our customers can get a better deal from us.
Tell us about operating efficiencies. It's a constant struggle, isn't it? Despite the fact that you are the most efficient housing finance company today, if you look at the branch model per AUM per branch, going forward, what is the strategy? How will you keep yourself there? Like you said, you want to better it. So how will you do it?
I mean, everybody wants to better it because we think there's still capacity which we can build and exploit our central operations better. There's a lot of science which goes behind geographical expansion on the opportunity which lies in each micro market where we open a branch. And depending on the opportunity, we put a branch of that particular, market, which is most opportune. And we are able to do it pretty well. And that is why I would not say we will expand
more aggressive. You think 23 is a good number?
Yeah, because that's the capacity I have to be exploited this year.
Right.
I mean, for future ready or, you know, future proof, we are investing a lot of money for next 3 to 5 years in this particular year, because that was also a promise in our IPO mandate.
All right, hold your thought on that. We will talk about PNB Housing Finance brand transformation, but that's right after the break. Stay tuned. Welcome back. I'm in conversation with MD and CEO of PNB Housing Finance Company, Sanjay Gupta. Talk about technology. You know, everybody in the BFSI sector, Sanjay, has this whole thing about getting digital. What is your own vision to tech transform PNB Housing Finance?
You know, Manisha, to be very frank, even in IPO roadshows, I talked very little about technology. Because technology is also very fundamental to the human nature and culture of the organization.
Interesting. So
what we brought in first was our core system, which cuts across the entire organization, right from a lead aggregation, not lead management, to retiring of a loan, to asset liability management, to interfacing with the regulators, with the vendors. So that platform is a single platform. Even when I will go to my office today and, you know, have to log in, I will log in on the same system. Otherwise, I'm useless. So that is one thing that we brought in 15, 16. Now we are doing front line, integration with digital applications, which is the fancy fare. So we are almost a zero tolerant error company. Most of our operations run at, tolerance levels of about 99% plus.
And that keeps your NPAs down.
Yeah, that keeps everything. I mean, NPA is a result of a one-day delinquency. So we keep our track on one-day delinquency. And we are able to do it because of technology. Technology is the way ahead to further improve efficiencies and reduce costs. And it has to be user-friendly, both for the customer and for your own people.
Take me through what you really focused on and how you changed PNB Housing Finance literally to become an absolutely customer-centric business.
Well, Manisha, to be very frank, the first and foremost thing that we did was internal repositioning of the brand. Internally, as I said, we brought in a lot of discipline. So we have a brand manual for internal use, right from presentations to our fonts to where the brand will be positioned, what will be the size. So we brought in a brand culture, and that helped us a lot in sort of the right target audience started watching us, started sort of, you know, noticing us. And obviously the marriage of the old legacy brand with more customer centricism, more, I would say, nimble-footedness, more aligned to the market turnaround times and our SLAs, you know, really, really helped us. So it was an ecosystem that we redefined.
Over 40 companies who have applied for a housing finance
license
in RBI. Competition's only going to get tougher and harder. How will Sanjay Gupta deal with it? What's the strategy?
I think competition always makes one sharper. So we welcome the competition. And in competition, you know, one element of business is very important is the treasury function. So today we have a very sort of a full-blown treasury. Our cost of funds are one of the lowest. Our asset liability management is one of the finest. Term management is finest. And I think more and more competition will only make us more and more alert, more agile, and it would be a better learning for all of us.
Anything that gives you an odd sleepless night when you look at the future?
Not really. The only thing is which bothers me at time is that maybe that I hope all the new housing finance companies and the banks which are foraying into housing finance give enough and plenty of importance into operations and technology. Because, you know, sales and underwriting is, I would say, only about 40%. Because it's an annuity product, it's a long-term product. Management of a mortgage and management of repayments takes away a lot of investment and a lot of, I think, thought process and a culture that you have to develop inside the company to give enough and plenty of importance to the back office, which I think a lot of people are missing upon.
Okay, so that's more like a cautionary note
that
you know, people keep their businesses smart and strong and not go crazy after growth, right? So let's come to the heart part of your company. So there is CSR. Everybody is supposed to put 2% of their profits into CSR. But then there's more to CSR than just that number.
Exactly.
Is that how you treat CSR?
Well, PNB Housing 2% Finance? Is just, I would say, a guidance figure.
Correct.
What we really want to do is give to the society at large and the society which is, you know, linked to us. And as you all, I mean, I don't want to call it as charity, but CSR begins at home. And we take very sort of, you know, conscious focus on the construction workers who actually give us our homes.
And they're all migrant laborers.
They are all migrant laborers. So we start right from the children. So we, you know, dovetail our efforts with mobile creches. We run daycare centers and informal schools. We run healthcare for them. And then for the construction workers, we always want to upgrade their skills. So along with CREDAI and NSDC, we do a lot of skilling across the country so that their wages better, their skills better, and also wastages come down on the construction side. And thus we also help the ecological balance. We are the first, I would say, company in this country which has raised green bonds, which is used only for building green residential units. And now the challenge which is coming our way is, because we want to do repeat rounds of it, is where's the labor which can build actually green buildings? So we are getting in touch with very, I would say, high-end skilling agencies and trying to mobilize, you know, the, I would say, the ordinary construction workers into green building technology. Another initiative that we are taking and we are pretty proud about it is we are getting raw labor from encatchment areas. So in India, there are encatchment areas. For example, Orissa gives the best plumbers. So we are getting the freshest from there, first killing them, and then putting them onto the construction side so that they don't start at the bottom of the pyramid.
And learn at the job,
and
which is a bigger
the job,
problem.
They go a little higher.
I can see how passionate you are about this.
It gives me goose pimples.
Well, so we do have a whole, you know, episode planned next week, Sanjay, on just focusing and probably capture some of these wonderful stories of upskilling construction finance laborers, and of course, providing that ecosystem to their families. Right. Thank you so much for joining
me. Thanks a lot for having me over.
Well, thanks to all of you for joining Sanjay and me on this very interesting conversation. Don't forget to tune in next week when we focus on PNB Housing Finance's CSR activities and the big impact that they're making.
Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.